Hi, my name is Josh Coyne, and I'm a student at Boston College, and I like gratitude. So much so that I decided to study it in its relation to stress, self-love, and happiness. I wanted to see exactly what effect gratitude could have on college students today. In my experiment, I took 30 Boston College students and sat them down in front of a laptop. Using the laptop, the 30 students filled out a survey used to measure the levels of stress, self-love, and happiness. They had no idea what the experiment consisted of, nor what they were being measured on. All they knew was that they were part of a thesis experiment. Students ranged from many different backgrounds, grades, majors and minors, ethnicities, and even religions. What was I looking for? Well, I wanted to see if the expression of gratitude could decrease college students' stress, increase their self-love, and boost their happiness. The second part of the experiment asked the 30 Boston College students to write about someone whom they are grateful for. The prompt read like this. Using this computer, please write about someone in your life whom you are grateful for. Explain why you are grateful for that individual, the impact that individual has had on your life, and what that person means to you. Why is this person a source of gratitude for you? Write as much or as little as you would like. All we ask is that you be honest. The person can be anyone who has physically entered your life, past or present, living or deceased. Take as long as you need. When the individuals finished writing about whom they are grateful for, they encountered a little surprise. They were asked to take out their cell phone and call the individual whom they wrote about, reading aloud exactly what they wrote. If the individual was deceased, they were asked to simply read aloud to the camera whom they had wrote about. Here's what happened.
You're the sweetest.
She better pick up.
Are you serious? Oh my god. He's driving. I have to do this. Are you serious?
You always make me feel so I can never tell you anything and be myself. No filters, though, just me. Thank you for letting me be myself.
Oh my god, thank you.
The more I begin to unfold how much my parents truly love me and want what's best for me, for that I am very blessed and very grateful.
Those people have made a large impact on me, and that I'm most grateful for are those that I no longer have in my life.
I grew up playing soccer with him even to this day. Yeah, playing soccer is something that I can continually find joy in whether I win or lose. Unfortunately, however, my dad passed away my freshman year of high school, so he's not here to continue to give me advice. This is especially relevant to females, an area in which I can definitely use his advice.
Right now, who comes to mind is my roommate, Christy. She's been my best friend for 4 years, and she knows pretty much everything about me. We can talk for hours and hours about the stupidest things.
My mom is seriously the best role model and one of the most important people in my life. She always listens to me and is very supportive. She provides me with great advice and is hilarious.
For example, during my sophomore year at PC, I'd go to the hospital for emergency surgery, and as soon as I called her, she took a train home from her job in NYC, grabbed the car, drove straight up to Boston without even hesitation.
Being a mother may be the most important role a woman has in her life. So I'm grateful that I will have a role model to look up to and make sure that one day to provide the same selflessness to my children that she has done for me throughout my life. No complaints or hesitation.
Muchas gracias por haber, mamá,
I'm gonna cry. Even when I'm having a tough week or day, she helps me look forward and see the bright side of things. I love her so much, and I don't know what I'd do without her.
Thank you, Mom.
Mom is my biggest role model and the greatest model of love in my life. I am grateful beyond expression for her love. She has taught me what it's like to be loved unconditionally. I feel like I know about God's love because of her love.
Et donc du coup là, je vais te lire ce que j'ai écrit à propos de pourquoi je suis reconnaissant. Donc je suis reconnaissant vers toi parce que tu as sacrifié vraiment presque tout pour nous aider, moi et Paolo.
I'm grateful for my mom because she's always there for me. Oh God. She's my rock when I need it, and she's always there no matter what. Sometimes I don't always show my appreciation for her, but she's really incredible. And I couldn't do half the stuff I do without her. She's amazing and I love her. So, there you go. Yeah, now I'm crying. Great. That's gonna go on the video.
No, I'm not. You put all your effort into raising me today, so I don't know if I would be how I'm like now. And all of my good parts I kind of attribute to you.
I'm also grateful for her laugh. Even though I'm not a funny person all the time, she always laughs, and it is a genuine laugh that makes me smile, and I'm grateful.
I'm grateful for the time I've had with him and for the continued lessons he teaches me, even though he's not always physically present.
Mom worked full time, and yet we still had only a can of soup and some bread to split between the three of us for a long time. I am grateful for my mom's efforts, as not only did we overcome our circumstances, but she made it possible for my brother and I to go to college. I am grateful for my mom, because in her, I have found not only a strong role model, but a best friend. My mom was always there for me, and the way she loves us, an unfailing love that we don't even deserve, is unbelievable.
At the end of the experiment, the 30 Boston College students were asked to retake the survey to measure if any of the emotions had changed. Fortunately, findings were significant. The expression of gratitude had indeed decreased stress, increased self-love, and boosted happiness among the 30 students. While further research will need to be done for more concrete conclusions, it is safe to say that those two words called thank you can go a long way to enrich our lives in ways we would never expect. As Elizabeth Gilbert says, in the end though, maybe we must all give up trying to pay back the people in this world who sustain our lives. In the end, maybe it's wiser to surrender before the miraculous scope of human generosity and to just keep saying thank you, forever and sincerely, for as long as we have voices. Thank you.